Binge eating is the consumption of a very large amount of food in a short period of time. To date, in our lab, we've been looking at primarily biological and genetic factors that might contribute to binge eating. And we found, as well as others, that binge eating is heritable. It is a behavior that is significantly influenced by one's genes.
So for this study, we were really excited to use our animal model of binge eating to examine strain differences in binge eating behaviors in rats. So we've looked at binge eating in humans, but we're able to kind of use this animal model to kind of look for some genetic differences possibly underlying these strains.
Unlike humans, animals don't have any of the cultural or psychological or psychosocial risk factors for binge eating. A rat could care less what it looks like. And so if you're really interested in isolating genetic or biological risk factors, using an animal model of the behavior can be a much quicker way.
So what we did was we took two different strains of rats, and then we put them through this model of binge eating where they have access to highly palatable, really tasty food, kind of like binge eating in humans.
The highly palatable food that we used, ironically enough, is actually Betty Crocker vanilla frosting. And what we found is that indeed, rates of binge eating were much higher in the Sprague Dawley rats as compared to the Wistar rats.
There seems to be some underlying genetic differences in binge eating, and that's really exciting for us eating disorder researchers.
Yes, this does take us one step closer to finding more effective treatments for binge eating and the disorders that are characterized by binge eating, like bulimia nervosa, binge eating disorder, etc.